Hi guys, welcome to Solar Tutorial. Today we shall learn example Java web application to create a request dispatcher object using one of the first way, that is by using request object. In the last session we have learned about how many ways to create a request dispatcher object. So there are three ways to create. First approach using request object. So in our servlet we have to configure a request dispatcher, and we need to configure destination servlet URL. Okay, and you can perform a forward or include. Okay boss, fine. So let us perform this, let us implement this first approach, that how to create a request dispatcher object by using login app. Okay, fine. So first of all, let me create a deployment identity structure in my Tomcat. So go back. So here I'm creating a new folder, 37 login web app, hit enter. Under this, we have to create the pages login.html, web.inf folder, under this web.inf, web.xml file, lib folder, under the lib folder, OLJWC14.jar, because I want to interact, my Java application need to interact with the database software, so I'm using OLJWC14.jar, and I do have one more directory whose name is classes under web.inf folder. And classes contain two Java files. First is source servlet, and second is destination servlet, and all the .class files. Okay, guys. First, let us see the picture representation about how can you able to work. So, example Java web application to create a request dispatcher object to create a login Java web application. Okay, boss. So here, let me give the name. This is my 37 login web app. Okay. So this is browser window contains the form page, username, password, login button, reset button, and I do have installed Tomcat web server, and web server contains my deployed web application whose name is 37 login web application. Okay, and I need to interact with the database software. So for that purpose I am using here Oracle database. So Oracle database is here. Fine, let me create this Oracle database and select and remove. I need the circle here. Delete. And I need circle or ellipse, you can call. Fine, this is my database, Oracle database. And let me give the name here for your better understanding. Oracle database software. Oracle database software, which is installed in my current machine. Okay, fine. Control A and let me change the color to black for better visibility. This Oracle database contains a table whose name is user list. And contains two to three columns. One is username and password. That's it. Let me keep it aside. The table is user list, and let me add some columns. So outline, no outline, fill outline. I need to use size and some more sizing in this way. Okay, this small size is more than enough. Okay, I need some more columns. Sorry, some more rows. This is second row and third row. Okay, more than enough to me. And username, password. Done, boss. Fine. So let me give the names here. The names, like I can call here column name, username, and here let me give password. Okay, control A, and let me somewhat minimize the size for better visibility, because size problems. Username, and password. Okay, these are the two columns. And let me enter the information here. Suppose I can say here is my Yogesh, or I can enter here Scott instead of Scott. Yogesh password, username is Yogesh, Yogesh B, and password is, suppose I entered password 1, pass 1. Okay, one more, suppose I entered Mosley, and here is my pass 2. Like this, some information which is available in user table. Let me give the name here, user table, user table. Okay, and put the arrow here, put the arrow. Okay, fine. Now fine, when the user enters the information like here, let me enter the names, Yogesh B, and password something like a input type pass 1. It should show star star star. Okay, password and star star star, or you can enter simply pass 1. When the user hits the login button, then the logic will be processed. The logic need to be processed based on this requirement. Okay, source solid, destination solid, and here I need to configure source solid and destination solid. Here is my source solid, and one more, destination solid. Let me give the names to those solid program. This is my source solid program, source solid dot java, and here is my destination solid. Okay, fine. So first of all, when the user gives the request to this login web app, the appropriate page will be loaded. Let me write here localhost. Localhost colon, my port number is 2020. I configured as a 2020/37 login app. This page will be loaded. 37 login app, and okay, whoops, fine. 37 login app, fine. When the user enters this URL, http://2020/37 login app, username enters login, the request will be sent to trapped by the Tomcat server. Request will be trapped by Tomcat server and sends that request to appropriate web application, that is 37 login web app. Now based on the URL you have configured, request will be trapped by again source solid program. Source solid program verifies the logic. Source solid program verifies the logics and interacts with the database software. Why? Because here we are writing database operations. Verifies, performs persistence logic and interacts with the database software, verifies the username and password. After verifying the username and password, if username and password matches, then request will be forwarded to destination program. Destination program shows the business logics. What are the business logic you are showing here? Welcome to solid program. Business logic. business logic. Okay, executes the business logic. Maybe hello world, what it may be. Okay, this is one case. This is one case. If username and password is valid, then this output will go to goes to, then this output will goes to, output will goes to browser window as a destination program. Output will go to browser window as a response, as a response. Okay, so this is first. Let me give the orders here. This is my request. Okay, fine. So it verifies one. Okay, next term, persistent logic verifies two with database software. Two, if both are matching, then sends the request to, instead of one, let me make it here control check 1.1 1.1. Come on. 1.1, and here is 1.2. Request will be forwarded to destination program. And what is the logic you have written? 1.3, and response will goes back to browser window. Destination program will response go to browser window. If not, if this case won't perform or your username and password is invalid, then in that case, directly response of first solid program only will go to browser window. This is second case. This is the second case. That is, username and password is invalid. Okay, so let me write here. Invalid username and password. Okay, so otherwise, we'll show here better one or two. Instead of making these two arrows here, let me remove these two arrows and show you here. Delete. Let me draw one more box here for valid and invalid. Okay, this is one more box for invalid and one more box for valid username and password. Okay, now we'll develop this web application now. So this is for, let me make it here invalid, and this is for valid. And let me use the arrow here from here to here. Okay, boss. Fine. Welcome, Mr. Yogesh, and invalid username and password. Invalid username or password. This I want to show you on my browser window. Okay, so this must be the response, and I'm expecting this to be displayed here in a red color. Okay, that decoration no matter. And here, welcome Yogesh B. So this logic I want to perform, but I forget to give the labels here. So here is 2 and here is 1.4. Okay, boss, fine. And these are the responses. Okay, both 2 and 1.4, both are responses. Now we'll develop this application now. To develop this application, first of all, I need to create deployment identity structure. Kadi paper?
Equis
slide. Okay, chalo, good luck. Okay, guys, well, now we'll develop this application. First of all, I need login web app, login.html, login.html, web.inf, web.xml. Already we have created this folder, 37 login web app. This folder we have created in a web apps, Tomcat 9, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9, web apps, and 37 login web app. Under this folder, we need a folder whose name is web-inf, web-inf. Under this web-inf, we need two directories. First is lib. Under this lib, we need one more classes. Okay, fine. Now I'm going to create HTML page, login.html. login.html. Okay, fine. So login.html already I created. Just I will go and copy and paste, not to worry. So here, alt f new HTML page. Control A, delete. I don't need all this stuff. Let me open some existing page which I do have already. Open with edit plus. Fine. So student login, how it looks, let me show you. How it looks like. Login. Okay, it looks like this one. Fine, shall we create in this way? Username and password. Okay, boss, fine. The source code, you can use same source code, not to worry. Input type, and I use a table and blah, blah, blah. Okay, fine. So once you hit this login, submit, where it goes? So you are using which method? Where is form tag? Here's a form tag, method action, and let me type here my servlet one or first URL, and let me give the method name as a, we can use get, and refresh, control F5, continue, and hit enter, submit. Look at here, first URL, username, and uname, both are uname. Let me change, okay, for time being. Okay, boss, fine. So I'm going to use this head title, student login, body background image, key one, student login, okay. Fine, boss. So I need this table. I think I don't need this tr tag here. Control S. Fine. Okay, boss, let's use this form page. Let us use this form page and configure it in your home. Control C. Here I pasted. So you can check it here. What I configured, HTML, but I need, if you are using the image, this image, let me have the image. Where is the key image? K. Yeah, I got key here. Copy this image. Also, I need to paste into my application under pasted, okay, key image. So let me change deployment data structure. What is that key image? Let me show you that key image. This is the key image, okay, fine. And let me add the image also. So here is my image. Home and key1.jpg, or you can use jpg image or png image, no matter. What is the image name? key1.jpg. Done, boss. So here I added the image also because for better visibility, and save by using login.html. What is the page name I used here? login.html. Okay, what code contains? Look at here, the title, the center I'm trying to keep, and the font for login student, and form tag, method get or post method, you can use the get or post, no matter. Action, first solid URL. So here are some of the break tags: table tag, tr tag, td tag, font, size, enter username and the color. Next, font tag gets closed here. Once font tag gets closed, then td tag close, and I need input type text, name is uname. Next, tr tag gets closed. This is first row. Let's move to second row. In the second row, font tag, enter the password, enter the password. Next, input type text, the name for this text is password, and tr close and tr open. Next, input type submit and reset. Okay boss, fine, my form tag is ready. Now let me save this page, let me save this code. So save, where to save? You have to save in C drive, where you have created 36 login app folder, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9, web apps, and 30 search for 37, and here to save. So login.html, hit save beside to webinf, okay, and under the 37 login web app. Okay, fine boss, so hit the save button. Yes, fine, just use control B, the page will appear like this. Okay, fine boss. Now next step, in webinf you have to create web.xml, lib, OWGC 14.jar, and source servlet and destination servlet. So let us create source servlet. Let us create a source servlet. So create the source servlet, copy file, new Java source servlet, which extends HTTP servlet. So let me save this program. Save. Where you have to save? Go to C, program files, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9, web apps, 37 login web app, webinf, classes, under the classes, just paste source servlet.java, save. Okay, saved. Now you have to perform some import operations. So import, print writer, IO, servlet exception, servlet, servlet request and response, and SQL, because you have to interact with the database software also. But what is left now? We forget to create the table. We forget to create the table. So let me check first, I do have table or not. Go to SQL plus. Yes. So Scott is his username I configured, and password I configured as a boss. Select star from user, select star from tab. Let me check what are tables are available. Account, person, student, department, users are there. Select star from users. So Yogesh boss admin, okay. Yogesh pass, boss, no pass, admin, administ. Okay, I do have table. You can create a table by using, so create table. You can create a table, create table. What is my table name is here? Users I created. Create table, users. And what are the column names I passed here? Let me check the column names. Uname and password, okay. Uname, varchar of, I passed here 20 to create the table. And password as a varchar of 20. Okay, create table name, and simply hit enter. Otherwise you can create users one if you're not happy with this. But again I have to insert the values. Okay, like by using insert into table, insert into users one values, like Yogesh B, comma, password. What is the image contains? Yogesh B and pass one. Yogesh B and pass one, semicolon. So Control C, Control V, and something like Bosley, and password is what is the password I configured in the image. You can have any password, no matter. Pass two. Otherwise, you can create anything like remote and no pass. Okay, boss. Like this, you can create a table. Otherwise, you can create anything. Create any table. Like it doesn't mean that create table. You can copy and simply you can paste here. Enter. Commit. Semicolon. Select star from users one. I'm not using old table. New table. Okay, this is the table. Describe. Users one. Okay, uname, password, varchar two, and these are the values. Fine, boss. So table also created in the database. Now let me start writing the source code of my Java. So what the source code I need? My form page is ready now. Now in my source solid, I need to import the packages. So import Java, import java.io.io exception, import java.io.printwriter, next import javax.solid.request dispatcher, request dispatcher, requestdispatcher, next import solid exception exception, exception, next import javax.solid. You can import HTTP packages like HTTP, then HTTP servlet request, then HTTP solid. Next, you can import HTTP servlet response, and let me import java.sql.star to SQL related operations. Okay, fine. Let me make my solid as a public, and I don't need all this stuff. So I need, we can use do post method or do get method, no matter. So here, what is the method type we are using here? Get method. If you get method, you can use do get also, no matter, or do post also. Public void. You can use do get or do post method, no matter. Then throws. So here you have to pass HTTP solid request. req, comma, HTTP solid response, res, which throws the servlet exception, comma, io exception, opening, closing curly, control shift w for word wrap, public void do get http servlet request, comma, http servlet and response. So here I am planning to call do post method. Okay, req, comma, response, request, comma, response. Okay, boss. So here is done. Control C, Control V. So instead of doGet, I'm passing here as a doPost. Either you call any method, doGet method or doPost method, no matter. The method will execute. Now let us write the logic now. First of all, I need response of printWriter object. So here is printWriter. PrintWriter pw is equal to response dot getWriter. GetWriter, and you can set the content type. So here response dot set content type. You can set the content type text slash HTML. Okay, now let us receive request processing logic. So I need string name is equal to request dot get parameter, request dot get parameter. So what are the parameter names? I need the parameter name. You can check it here. What are the parameters name we have configured? For name, username, I configured uname. So copy and paste here. Okay, I want to get password also. String pass is equal to, not is equal to, it's an assignment operator, request dot get parameter. So get parameter, and here to configure as a pass. So here is pass. Okay, fine. Okay, boss, now I got request processing logic. Now let me perform persistence logic. Let me write the persistence logic. Spelling mistake and typing mistakes are there. So let me work with the try and catch block. So in the try block, let me perform first class.forName. Let me load the driver class name, class.forName. So let me load the driver class name. oracle.jdbc.driver.oracle.driver. Next, I need connection con assignment operator driver manager dot get connection. And let me pass the URL first. What is the URL? The URL to pass JDBC colon oracle colon thin colon at the rate localhost 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 colon port number 1521 up to here protocol. This is driver name. Oracle installed in my current machine and Oracle running on port number called 1521, and the service ID is ORCL. Okay, boss, and the username I configured here, Scott, and password for this username is I configured as a boss. Okay, fine. Next up, I need to work with the prepared statement PS assignment operator con dot prepare statement. Now just fire the query. What is the query? Select star from, what is the table name I configured here? You can check out the table name. Users1, U-S-E-R-S-1. users1, where select star from users1, where what are the column names are configured here? Check the column names in SQL plus uname and pwd, where uname assignment operator question mark, because I have to pass the parameters, and pwd password assignment operator question mark. Okay, fine boss. Okay, and now let me set the parameter ps dot set string 1 comma name. What is the name here? This name. Copy and paste here. Okay, and ps dot set string. So here is 2 comma semicolon pass. Copy, and here is passed. These two variable has been passed. Now let me work with now result set. Result set RS is assignment operator PS dot execute query. Fine, the query get execute. Now let me check RS dot next, and in the else block. Okay, now in the else, we'll perform request dispatcher logic forwarding method. We'll perform request forwarding request mode of solid chaining. You will perform forwarding request mode of solid chaining. Okay, or you can perform collaboration. Okay, and here we'll perform, in the else block we'll perform control X, and let me write here only for better understanding. And here we'll write including request mode of solid chaining, or you can call collaboration. That's it. Include request mode of solid chaining. But here we'll create the object by using request object. We'll use the object by using request. Okay, so request dispatcher QUEST, request dispatcher PATCHER, request dispatcher RD assignment operator, request dot get a request dispatcher. Here to pass the URL. Okay, fine. So what is the URL I want to configure? Suppose take example dest URL and source URL. Dest URL, fine. Okay, dest URL. Configuring slash is optional here. So slash is optional. Slash is optional in dest URL. Okay, either you pass or don't pass. Next, let us forward now. Request dispatcher RD dot forward. We can call the method whose name is forward, and you need to pass the parameter request comma response. Request comma response. Fine. req res. So here is my request, and here is the response. Done. If the logic is not okay, request comma next, request if resultsnext is true, then request dispatcher, I'm forwarding the request to destination URL. Okay. And if now in the case of including, so here, just I'm showing here, I need request dispatcher object again. Control C and paste. I need only login. What is the name? I need only the page name. I am trying to include my including request mode. So here simply, let me write the response and send to my login.html. Okay. Here login.html. And before that, let me write my, where is my out dot object? Where is the out object? And object out is the print writer object pw. Okay, pw.println. Let me write here pw.println. So pw.println. I want to keep in center. Font is h1. Again h1, and I want to keep somewhat break. Okay, otherwise let me keep here font tag and copy and paste. Where is my font tag? This is my font tag. Okay, and here is my instead of h1, let me keep here font tag, size 50 and blue. Let me use a red color, font size 50, but I want to keep in center. That's it, that is my intention. Hurry. Okay, font size center, instead of blue I want to keep it red. I could not use here double quote, I should use single quote here. And here single quote, here is single, done. Okay, so here invalid username or password, please try again. Okay, fine was. Now let's work with now exception E, and here I want to print that exception. So system.out.println E, that's it. Okay, but we haven't forwarded, so let me include rd.include of. So what need to include? Request comma response. rd.include of request comma response, done. Fine boss. So this is my catch block, end of do post method, and end of source servlet program. Okay, fine. Next step, driver loaded connection, JWC colon, American colon, thin colon, local loss, 1521 war sales, got boss, select star from users, USERS1, where uname and PWD, name pass, execute, request mode, okay, and including request mode. Okay boss, fine. Get request dispatcher, one is forwarding, one is including, that's it. Fine, let us create now destination servlet. What is the servlet name? Destination servlet. Now I need to have file new Java So here I will use the same source code. Control A, Control C, Control A, Control Escape, Control A, Control V. Just I will change the class name and I will remove some unnecessary code. Paste. Okay, fine. I need print writer object. I don't need request dispatcher here. Solve exception, SQL solve request. I don't need SQL here. I don't need SQL. Okay. And let me save this one. So file. Where I'm modifying? You should not modify here. You should modify in destination solid. Destination solid. Okay, fine. So you have to install this one. Where is the source solid? I think you change the class name. Pay attention. Copy. No name. And here you have to change. Control V, pasted. Simply paste. Okay. Here you don't need all this stuff. SQL you don't need. Don't need request dispatcher. Okay. Fine. Control Shift W for word wrap. Same. So here I don't need. This also I don't need. Forwarding, because request will be sent to second. I don't need all these. Okay, I don't need all these. Request dispatcher. So here also I don't need catch block, no, don't. Do post method, that's it. Okay, here I will change. Center font 50, I want to give is green. Okay, invalid. So in shop invalid username and passwords. Successful login. Successful login. Successful login. Welcome to. Welcome to. Welcome to home page or destination page. Okay, and Mr. or Miss colon, and here plus I want to configure the same name here. Okay, fine. So just save. How will you save? Use the name. Copy, file, save. Where will you save? Go to C drive, program files, Apache Software Foundation. Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9, web apps. 36, 37 login web app, webinf, classes, and here you have to save. First, destination solid. Hit the save button. Saved now. Okay, boss. Fine. So here, just use some break tag. Okay, fine. Welcome to home page. Break tag. Login, successful login. And or you can call valid credential. Fine, boss. Done. Now next step, what is left now? Now web.xml is left now. File, new, others, go to XML. So I need web app. Web app. I need my servlet. Close tag of servlet. I need servlet name. Servlet hyphen name. Close tag of servlet hyphen name. I need servlet class. Close tag of servlet class. Okay. And I need servlet mapping. Servlet hyphen mapping. Close tag of servlet hyphen mapping. I need servlet name. And I need URL pattern here. URL hyphen pattern. Close of URL hyphen pattern. URL hyphen pattern. Okay, I need these two tags for two servlets. Servlet mapping and paste. Okay, and what to configure for welcome page also. So let me use source servlet name. So here is my source servlet. Copy. Go to here. What is the class name? Source servlet. Okay. What is the name here? Or you can call. We can use same name as a source servlet. Okay, source servlet or source name. Source servlet name, no matter. And what is the URL? What is the URL we have configured here? First URL we have configured, or you can configure source URL. Source, source. Source URL. Source URL. Fine. Use this URL from HTML page configured here. Source URL. What is the name? Source name? Source S name. Okay, boss. Fine. Next, I need destination. What is the destination I have configured? Destination URL. For forwarding request mode. Dest URL. So here copy and configure for dest URL. So here dest URL slash dest URL. I need destination servlet. Scroll up. What is the class name? Copied and pasted here. Pasted. So yes, name. Destination servlet name. Okay, boss. Fine. Again, we need to configure welcome file list. Welcome hyphen file hyphen welcome file list. Control C. Close welcome file list. Welcome file. Welcome file. Close of welcome file. What is my welcome file name? Login.html. Login.html. Okay, boss. Fine. Welcome file list. Welcome file. Okay, fine. Welcome file is input.html. I need not give the slash here. So slash is optional. Just next step is save. File, save. Where will you save? Go to C drive or otherwise web apps. 37 login web app. Webinf. Look at here. You can see the directory. You can see the directory structure and observe. Within the webinf, beside to lib. Within the webinf and beside to a lib. Save. C and then program files. Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9.0, web apps, and login web app within the webinf. And here is my web.xml. Web.xml. Hit the save. Okay, boss. Fine. Now, what is the last step now? Add the OJVC 14.jar. So let me search for OJVC 14.jar. Already I do have in my web apps only. Program files. Just gather OJVC 14.jar. Webinf. I do have for Oracle. Okay, boss. So simply I'm copying. So properties. What up file is jar. OJVC 14.jar. Right click, copy and paste into your lib folder. Hurry, yeah. Where is your lib? 20 web apps, 37 login web app, lib, and paste at boss. Fine. Now the last step, compile the servlets. How will you compile? Go to command prompt, classes, cmd. Java C. Destination servlet.java. Next, Java C source servlet.java. Successfully compiled. Now, next step, start the server. That is Tomcat server. How will you start? Go to C drive. Glass program files. Apache Software Foundation. Tomcat 9. Web apps. Not web apps. Bin. Then Tomcat 9. Run as administrator. Hit the S button. I think again some issues. Okay, no issue. It is starting now. Will take time. Till then, let me go to browser. Localhost 2020. Server started now. Now you can see here. Okay, fine. Server started. Go to manage. Click on manager app. Username and password is boss. Boss. Hit the sign in. Scroll down for 37. Login web app. Hit the login web app. Oh, minimize. Okay, fine boss. Username, password, student login. We can see here, enter username and password. Somewhat minimize, okay, fine. Enter username, password, student login. And here, what is the username and password? You can check it from database. Pramod and no pass. So here, Pramod. NOPASS. Hit the submit button. Not found. Source URL. Oh, what is that URL? Let me check. SOURE URL. What is the page? Where is the page? HTML page. Okay, copy and go to web.xml. What is the URL configured? Oh, paste. Save. Fine. Try again. Control F5. Remote. No pass. Submit. For not for not found. It is there. It is already have been configured. Let me check. Classes. Yeah, it's there. It's there, everything is there. Let me keep it for charging. Charging is for 34 minutes only. Hold on, wait. Okay guys, the issue was raised here, 404 not found, just because of I am too poor at typing and I made mistake here. Instead of servlet mapping, I made a servlet. So it should not be servlet sweater. It should be servlet. Servlet copy and again paste. So this type of mistake happened because of copy and paste. So do careful while copying and pasting. So also do confirm. That you are typed up properly, servlet everywhere. Okay, so do correction here. Servlet mapping. Done. Check it here. Is it reloaded? Yeah. Reloading completed. Done. Reloading context with name 37 login web app is completed. Now let's try one more time. So go back and just refresh. Let me hit Pramod, and what the username I configured in my Oracle? SQL plus. For Pramod, I configured the password as a no pass. Okay? So enter NOPASS. Okay, no matter. Either you will get valid user or invalid user. Hit the submit button. Invalid username or password. Please try again. Okay? And this is your form page. Actually, I made huge break tag. So because of that reason, you can see this much of gap. So why username and password is Pramod one? Let me check once again. There might be some database issue. No error, any error. Okay, capital P. You can check it here, caps P. One thing, I would like to give one more point. SQL keywords are not case sensitive, as well as SQL table names. SQL column names are not case sensitive. Either you can use uppercase, lowercase. But whereas data is case sensitive, tuple data. Look at here, Pramod P is capital, caps, uppercase. So because of that reason, it's an invalid. Okay. So let's try by using lowercase again. Let me go back and control plus. So for visibility, I typed here lowercase p. Now I am using uppercase P and no pass. Is any space exist? No. Any space? No.
So hit this hit the submit button. Now it should get my web page. What is the web page name? The connection descriptor was user bag, client was ORCL. What the issue? Listener refused the connection with the following error. Means it is not allowing to get my connection. So let me check the error. Okay guys, the issue is with the submit. Successful login, control F5. And when I go back, when I enter something like other than password 123111, which is not a password, the mistake I made here is invalid username and password, try again. And you can check it here, control minus, control minus, control minus. Okay. Invalid username and password. Username and password. Why it is coming? Because why it was not coming? Last time the issue was I kept multiple jars. Memory leak issue was coming just because of OJDBC 14.jar I kept here in my lib folder. It should not be available here. It should not be here because it is trying to create a connection pool objects from here. In the last session, I taught connection pool concept. In the last session, the memory leak issues was coming because of in last sessions of Tomcat connection pool with JDBC connection pool with Oracle database, I kept OJDBC 14.jar in lib folder of Tomcat, lib folder of Tomcat. Okay, so and today while creating 37 login web app again I kept OJDBC 14.jar in lib folder of 37 web app. Okay, let me give the path also. Webinf and lib. So here I kept, so to overcome that one. Okay, so remove OJDBC 14.jar from either of lib folder. So let me close the server, stop the server and delete from Tomcat lib OJDBC 14.jar. Delete. Yes, deleted now. Now this error won't appear now. So remove or delete. Okay. Now next step is start the server and test your application. So till the server starts. Next step, test the web application. How to test? Open the browser and test. /37 login web app. In destination subreddit. Let me recompile. Okay. And reload the application. Reload. Okay, fine. So we'll try with different user. Select star from users 1 and describe users 1. Okay, fine. Boss play pass 2. Hit the submit button. Successful login. Welcome to home page or destination page, Mr. Mrs. or boss play. Okay, fine boss. Go back and hit something, some different username like Rajesh. And password is something, password submit. Invalid username and password. Please try again. Student login. Username and enter username, password, submit button. Okay, boss. Fine. Okay. So this is the example to work with the to work with require dispatcher object. Okay, fine. Using approach one. Now we'll work with the servlet context. Okay, boss, fine. Now let us see example Java web application using about three ways to create a require dispatcher object using approach 2 using servlet context object. Okay, fine.